Mr. Ritwika, 3D is here to stay, and there is so much to learn and so much fun behind this technology. Because of this, I am producing my ultimate series tutorials on 3D video production. It will have at least 4 parts, and in the first part, I will show you how to make a completely adjustable 3D rig like this one. In the second part, I'll show you how to calculate the axial distance between 2 cameras and how to adjust the convergence. In the third part, I'll show you how to shoot 3D, and in the fourth part, we'll go into the post-production. First, get yourself a pair of 3D glasses. Without it, you can't watch any of my 3D examples or even edit your own 3D videos. There are many competing 3D technologies because 3D is still maturing. Because of this, there are many types of 3D glasses, which means you can decide to spend only $1 and get a cheap paper anaglyph glass like this one, or may decide to spend a couple $100 and buy a shutter glass. To make things even more complicated, there are lots of technologies in shutter glass as well, and none of them are compatible with each other. To keep things simple and inexpensive at the beginning, I strongly recommend you get a paper anaglyph glass like this one. Although anaglyph glasses may not give you high quality color corrected image, it's good enough to edit your 3D video. And in post-production, you can always convert your video to be compatible with any other 3D technology. Paper anaglyph glasses come with 2 different colored lenses. Usually the colors are complementary, like red cyan, red blue, magenta green, yellow blue, etc., etc. Surprisingly, you will get a better 3D experience using the cheap paper glasses than the fancy plastic ones because the color on the paper glasses frame is much more accurate than the plastic ones. In the plastic one, you will see ghosting where you will see double of the image and you may even get a headache. So save yourself a couple of bucks and a migraine and stick with the paper glasses. Ready? Let's build our 3D rig. This is my design. You can easily adjust the interaxial distance between the 2 cameras, lock it securely, and even adjust their convergence. In fact, I can even shoot 3D handheld. To build this rig, you will need 2 24-inch slide calipers. I bought mine from Harbor Freight, and it's item 96509. The rest of the tools are pretty standard. You'll need a power screwdriver, some butterfly nuts, drill bits, 1/4-inch screws, Allen key, washers, and a quick release. You'll also need a hacksaw or a small table saw like this one to cut the aluminum flat. Each caliper has 2 jaws, the upper jaw and the lower jaw. Unscrew the upper jaw so it can move freely. Now that your upper jaw is loose, take it out from the top and slide it in from the bottom. Now take both of the jaws off of the other caliper and slide it into the other end of the first caliper, like this. Now you bore a hole on each jaw, like I have done here and here. Without its jaws, the remaining caliper is basically a scale. We will cut 2 small pieces from the scale so it can cover the end-to-end distance between 2 jaws. This piece will be our camera's platform. These are my cut pieces. I drilled 2 small holes on the sides so it can match the holes on the jaw. And I fix it on the jaw by using 2 small screws and nuts. As you can see, I've attached my platform to both of the jaws securely by using the screws and nuts. Now when I move it, the whole thing moves together. I've also drilled a couple of big holes on the platform so I can mount my camera by screwing into its tripod hole. Yeah. Lastly, I've drilled a center hole on the caliper and attached a quick release plate to it by using a long screw. I've mounted the other camera on my rig, and now my 3D rig is ready for shooting. Stay tuned for the next installment, where I'll show you how to calculate interaxial distance between the cameras, and also tell you how and when to converge your cameras. If you found this tutorial helpful, please visit www.rennow.org. It's a nonprofit that helps underprivileged artists by giving them training and tools.